What's the connection between Corby and an enormous amount of porridge found on Mars?
Well, that would be definite evidence of life on Mars if they found a bowl of porridge.
Yeah. And then three bears.
Yeah. And then the probe would be able to determine whether it was too hot, too cold, or indeed just right.
Just right.
Is it the Scottish Space Programme? We'll send them porridge to Mars.
Cast your mind back to June-ish 1969.
Right. Okay.
What happened then? Big famous thing.
The old moon landing.
The moon landings. Yeah. Now, in the 230-odd-thousand miles from Earth to the moon, there's a lot of boring time in which the three sitting in their podule are chatting to Mission Control. Houston said, and in Corby, England, an Irishman, John Coyle, has won the world's porridge-eating championship by consuming 23 bowls of instant oatmeal in a 10-minute time limit. Over. Actual transcript. And Apollo 11 said, I'd like to enter Aldrin in an oatmeal-eating contest next time. He's on the 19th bowl. Roger. which deathless conversation led to NASA getting rather obsessed with Corby and porridge. And so it named a crater on Mars Corby.
If there is any life on Mars, aren't they going to be angry that everywhere's been named according to some NASA-based in-joke system?
The rules that govern the naming of craters on Mars, they have to be named after towns in the world with a population below 100,000. The ones beginning with C include Cadiz, Cairns...
Cadiz.
Thank you. Cadiz. Minus five. Cairns. How do I say Cairns? Oh, Cairns. Canberra. Canberra, similarly. Charleston. How are you going to say Charleston, your best Southern Belle accent?
Charleston.
Oh, it's like a drunk aunt, isn't it? And crew.
Crew?
Crew, right.
Do they have outside, you know, when you go into crew, is there a sign that says twinned with a crater on Mars?
Is that photo taken from the moon or is that taken from Mars? Because the Earth's probably too big, isn't it?
Well, it could be a graphic image, and if it is a graphic image, whenever you see on the news graphic representations of Mars, it usually says, courtesy NASA JPL, Jet Propulsion Lab, but by a weird coincidence that only happens in the land of QI, the name of the senior graphic programmer at NASA is Corby Waste.
We're all going to live on Mars in the end.
How are you? You sure about that?
Yeah.
Yeah? That 1950s boys' adventure book isn't necessarily the truth.
I didn't get it from there. No. I got it from Channel 5.
Open your desk.
They said the sun.
Wait a minute. You can get Channel 5.
That is you.
What's me?
That's an Alan Potato Head. I don't know.
Yeah, I watched this documentary and they said eventually the sun will explode or implode or something and everything will be gone.
That won't help Mars, will it?
Including Earth. And so on the way out, we have to stop at Mars.
Oh, I thought you meant there was a services there.
There'll be someone trying to get you to join the RAC in the car park.
Thank you for watching. Do remember to subscribe to the QI channel and click here to watch more videos.